Okay, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to MBTV. We're back in week three of the Nations Cup. I'm Captain Lust, Community and Public Relations Manager at Tailwind Entertainment. I'm joined by E-Man, my regular co-caster, who wasn't in with us for the last stream. Thankfully, Bravandafar stepped in because you had a sore throat, didn't you, E-Man?
Lavanda did a great job, and yes, I had no voice. I sounded like a squirrel.
Rough,
But I'm
you had
back. I'm
caster
healthy
sickness.
now. It's good to
Well,
be
yeah.
back, Lost.
Oh, it's good to have you back. You know it is.
Yes, it is
And
always a pleasure to speak with you.
it's a nice match to come back in. Last match we had a real thriller. I went to the
A
tie break.
tiebreaker. Yes, that's kind of
Yeah,
why I regret it. Oh my gosh, that was very exciting.
it was exciting.
And it was a new map, too. A very
Italy
hot
versus the
one.
Czech Republic. Yeah, it was a great one. It was the new map. Well, what Drakesdorf, you mean?
Yes, Drakestav.
Well, yes, that's not one of the most popular maps, but it has I don't know, it provided some good entertainment at least, I thought. It was good to
Half
watch.
the fun in Warband is the map, so as long as they keep creating new ones.
Yeah. Maybe, I don't know. I don't know, maybe that's wrong, but whatever.
Maybe it's wrong to want diversity and variety in life, Lost?
Yeah,
Okay.
but as long as it has to stay
Okay.
like balanced and fun, because
Yeah.
otherwise
The
it's
competitive mindset, final
Yep.
destination, no items, box only. Okay. Okay, Lost. It's Palladians only. That's why we never see Kurgit. What's wrong with the Kurgit? Whatever happened to the Kurgit native
Know
leader?
what's wrong with the Kurgis because they have a bow and a horse. It doesn't make any sense. You can't.
You can't have both.
They were just ridiculously overpowered in real life, and in Warband it's the same. The only reason they lost was because they had to do sieges, and we don't play siege, so no Kurgis.
Horses couldn't break buildings.
Yeah, like arrows couldn't break buildings. That was their main problem. Like they couldn't run away and shoot at buildings. It didn't work. They tried running away from buildings and shooting at them, but just not there. Anyway, tonight's match, Ukraine versus Germany. Everyone thought Ukraine and Germany were going to win this group, except for maybe Scandinavia. But they didn't, and they both lost to Scandinavia and both beat Spain. They're now on 3 points each, and it's the last week of Group D, so we're pretty much
What are we,
this match this
Lost?
this th we're pretty much the deciding point of the group. But whoever wins this goes through, whoever loses this goes out. And I think for either of these teams to go out is a bit of a shocker. Are you in the server, E-Man?
Oh no, I'm not. I
That's
forgot what server name it
important.
was. Yeah, I'll get in there. You tell me in chat which server that is. But
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and do that.
so whoever loses gets an octagon.
They write out, yeah. And I think both teams will be really gutted about that. I mean, Germany won last year. Ukraine, I think, got semi-finals maybe, or at least quarter-finals. And they're a big warbanding nation, Ukraine, famous for their infantry prowess. And they wouldn't want to go out in the group stage. That's embarrassing.
That would be. How do you live that down?
They would, yeah. I mean, they might even go out before UK do, and that would be really embarrassing. UK team this year,
That is
bit
a
of a
market
beast though.
shame completely. And do
It
you?
is, yeah.
Oh, there you told me the server. Awesome. Thank you. I'm joining.
UK team will get a nice quarterfinal finish and roll with that. We could do better though. Who knows? In the meantime, the teams look pretty full though. They're pretty much ready to go, I think. We got Foams refereeing. Good job. Always nice to have
We have
Foams
a
around.
referee?
Yeah.
Oh my god, things got nice and fancy all of a sudden. We
It's a
got
nice
referees in the Nations Cup. No
yeah. It's a nice
tomfoolery.
development because it keeps the match moving, flowing. You don't have to worry about big long breaks or and arguments can be resolved a bit faster. I mean, this it's pretty much a response to the ECS finals. But it's worked out pretty well so far. Every match I've seen has gone really smoothly, and even when problems have come out, they've just been dealt with, and everyone's been pretty happy. There is also a Russian stream for this, so if you are Russian speaking and you can't understand a word I'm saying,
Why are you watching this?
yeah, while we can still enjoy the pictures and E-Man's sort of excited tone, you can get into
Yeah,
that,
you can
but
understand a few things.
yeah, it's about the tone of the voice.
Pick up a few words here and there.
Exactly, but if you'd rather just watch one in Russian, you can find that. I don't know, I've not got a link for you, but there is a Russian stream, and you can find it probably pretty easily by going to the Twitch streams and Warband there, so check them out. And there's lots of commentators in here. I'm sure they're going to do a great job. In the meantime, on our stream though, we're pretty
Not
much set to go.
Russian, but we're pretty ready.
No, we're not Russian,
We rush it
unfortunately.
again in the game because I think we're almost ready.
I think we are almost ready. The maps and factions. The first map and faction is going to be filled by the river. Sarenids versus Nords, is that right? Have I set
A
that up right? Is that right on
classic.
the splash screen?
It says Sarenids versus Nords, my friend.
Okay,
A
that's good.
classic map. Classic
Yeah,
matchup.
I guess I like Sarenids versus Nords on this map.
Love them. In
I think
fact,
Nords probably a bit stronger, just because Nords are a bit stronger, and you got like the extra, you got the free javelins from the Cav. That's the real issue here, for Sarenids. But and obviously the better infantry. But the Sarenid Cav is quite nice, even if it's paper. And
it's
you could
nice
definitely.
paper. You could fold it in shapes, make it a crane, maybe
Yeah.
deer.
Could have deer Cav, like Lord of the Rings and stuff, or the Hobbit, wherever they have that deer, that elf riding
Oh,
that
you've
deer.
seen the new ones? The new Hobbits.
That's the old one. I've seen the new ones, yeah, but I mean that was the first one. When you got that elf riding on that deer. That looks awesome. I'd love to ride a deer one day. Actually, no, I wouldn't. That sounds cruel.
Yeah, my memories of those films are as short as a Hobbit stature. Just
Yeah,
don't
that's
last
true.
long.
I don't really remember what happened in the films, but I just remember enjoying it. It was cool.
I remember
I like being back in.
potatoes.
I like being back in the world of Lord of the Rings. You know what I mean? Like, I don't care. They could make like a really bad film. They probably have done. I just wouldn't notice. I
You
just be
like
like,
the
yeah.
universe?
Yeah, I
I
just like
guess that's
being
why
in the
franchise
Mirth.
is like Star Trek. Survive and endure for so long. People
Yeah,
don't
I'm
actually like the cheesiness of that particular episode or series. They like the universe.
just like being there. Just like
Yeah,
being.
just
It's like
like
going around
chilling with these.
space. I like to see new space colonies and stuff. That's just cool.
You should play EVE Online.
Nah, I play Mount & Blade. Like I don't even care. I probably could even like other games. Nah,
I like
that's
the
not trending.
fantasy world of Calradia.
Well, yeah, it's fantasy. It's fictional, but it's kind of there's no real fantasy, I guess. It's more
There's a
like.
little bit of fantasy. In my Mount and Blade, I fought demons and skeleton warriors.
Really?
Well, that's more of a nightmare
Anyway.
than a fantasy, but yes. Nonetheless.
I think we're live now, so
Oh, let's get the intro up in
let's
this.
get buddy going. We in?
Yes, we are, my friend.
Okay, fantastic.
Although I was a little slow on putting this up, but nonetheless, there we go.
That's all right. Yeah, it's great to be live. Class setups, we've got some free cav on either side, three infantry for the Germans with two archers. The Ukrainians gone for two infantry and three archers. Not bad. Nice choices. They got Bendetto playing on the Ukrainian side, Volscian and Eivindir as the archers.
And of course, poop. You can't forget Mr. Poop.
Mr. I poop ate an apple poop. Oh, first kill and
Where is the
first
first
kill and
kill?
it's I think someone in the forest got taken out by Volscian and
Opportune shot right there by Volshin. Great to
and then
know.
proceeded just to say lel. Oh, we're having a little bit of an issue. Apparently the quality settings on the stream are not enabled, but it's not like they should be enabled automatically, which is.
What has happened?
The quality settings are not enabled on the stream, but they should be enabled by default.
Oh, I mean, is that the new Twitch update where you actually gotta right click on the video to switch the source? That's what I know to do.
Oh, maybe. Maybe you have to right click on the video.
I think they updated Twitch to do that. Yes, you have to actually right click the video and change source quality.
Okay.
Just so you know, guys, Twitch is going under updates, but we're still the same old Warband. Still the same old
So,
MTV, MBTV, I'm sorry.
we are indeed, yeah. And the flag has spawned now, in the middle of the two teams. Remember, Germany is a little bit behind.
Germany,
They
a
did lose that.
bold
They did lose one of their
push.
cav to a Volscian snipe. But Mark comes in with a
Oh,
couch lance,
beautiful
pulling one back against
kill.
Eivindir. Bring out Archer. But Ukrainians have the extra cav count here. I'm just concerned about the cav quality. We've got Flex, Sumrak, and Rich. Rich is probably the strongest cav out of those, I say. Flex already loses his horse. Rich and Sumrak coming in with the couch lances, trying to get some kills here. Do get the knockdowns, but don't actually get any damage done. Germans
They're
still looking
coming for
pretty strong on
another
the flag.
pass.
They've got the higher up flag as well. Sumrak coming in, so let's get the damage done. But the issue is these paper horses that just aren't really cutting it with the knockdowns. In the meantime, it's a really close round, 5-on-5 here. An extra German does go down to Rich, and Rich with a triple kill here.
Oh, Renek. getting wrecked. Oh no, he stands up amidst the fighting. He gets killed by Flex at the end now.
Yeah, I think Flex, has he found himself a horse there, or yeah, he's found himself a hunter, and the Ukrainian cav has really done some nice work there. The flag is still a bit high for the Germans, but there's 50 seconds left and just two Germans here. And they're just gonna continue to get bumped.
Oh, no, too little
until they go down. Charlie does go down. And Rich showing real quality there. I did single him out as one of the stronger players there. Yeah, and he's really
Spear was able to shoot the whole time, but unfortunately, I think the Germans pushed in too early. They got kind of manhandled by the Ukrainian cav.
Yeah, they did in the end. Yeah, but the Ukrainian cav took a bit of time to get into it, but once they got there, they really didn't up at all. Rich not able to, or he hasn't, perhaps he's chosen not to buy a big horse as well. I was speaking to someone on Reddit as well, who's posting comments on the threads that I put up. And he said one of the things that helped me was like when you point out specific players, so I should try and do that, at least. I certainly think one to watch out here for is if you can spot him as Rich on his horse.
Well, if we're gonna call out players, please spam Kappa. Please follow his name. No, but that's wonderful, that listening to the criticisms of the people that watch. As always, yeah. Folk, you can always tweet us. Let us know right on the spot the criticism that you have in your mind. On the
course,
tip of
yeah.
your tongue, let it out.
Yeah. It doesn't have to be
in
important.
In 140 characters or less.
You can hashtag Nations Cup for that, and that'll help us to find your tweet. You actually have a couple of tweets in already as well. Any chance to get the option to change quality of stream? Yeah, I think people had a bit of a problem with the stream and it just being a little bit slow. It's unfortunately Twitch is a bit of an issue. Maybe if you can right click the stream and go quality. Oh no, that doesn't do it properly though. It's not. That's actually not. That won't make it any faster. That would just like do something else. So
change
don't
the...
ignore your man's suggestion.
I don't know. That's what I do when the Twitch is bad. But I will mention, from our end, all I can control is seeing how many frames are dropped. And we're not dropping any frames, so...
Yeah, it's changed, unfortunately.
The intertubes are just too jammed, man. Too much
I wonder if it's
on.
To do with the American server or something like that it's doing. I guess. I don't know. Who knows?
But let's not focus on things we cannot fix, but...
That's true.
Instead on...
What you want to... speaking of things to focus on, there's a German archer called Triari. And if you can spot him, you can see him always trying to find the best position and making some killer shots as well. So he's definitely one to watch out for.
He is one that the Ukrainians are watching out for, because they peppered him a little.
Yeah, he's one of the best archers in the scene. Easily.
Okay,
I've suffered many a
headshot.
Many a headshot to Triari, yeah.
Sumaro
he's a real headshotter.
Is leading the Ukrainians over to try to take the flag. Spear, for the Germans, is already set up at the ruins, getting some nice shots off. Still out there shooting. There's a bit of a
even they're going down very early on again. I think he's having a few problems here. The Ukrainian archer. The cav are mainly fighting over by the flags already.
Oh, the German have an advantage upper hand right now in the cav.
Yeah, Cermak has gone down.
With the rest of the Germans arriving.
I think Rich and Flex need to sort of wait for their teams to support them because they're taking a big beating from the German cav already.
They wisely pulled back for the team to arrive across the river.
But the thing is, I don't know how the Germans got there first. Oh. They just kind of rushed the ruins and got there a bit earlier and the Ukraine's now just a couple players down.
Poop's in trouble.
Yeah, he's in real trouble. Nero's coming over to start harassing him.
Oh my
Running
god.
Running Kabib brings down Flex as well, so it's just Rich
kill.
Left. Motion does get a nice shot, and Rich gets that couch chance to bring it back into the running for Ukraine. They're 5-on-6 right now, but Rich has got a real mountain of work.
About to go ham on Poop. Nope, he misses.
Rich is getting a little bit caught up as well by the bridge here.
Beautiful shot by Volshin. I now notice there's no death dialogues. We will turn them on, folk. I apologize for that.
Or death dialogues.
The things
oh, you have no
death.
Who? Oh, yeah, that's important, yeah.
Yeah, I filmed things. But nonetheless, Volshin is fighting Renek over in the corner, and we got... Wow, Poop is still alive! Jesus Christ!
He is. He's
that's
a real warrior.
Sturdy stuff. There's some corn up
the
in
issue,
there.
The issue though right now is that the flag is up really high up for Germany. There's only 15 seconds left, so the chances are... Unless Ukraine can get these last players down.
Poop finally goes down. They flush
yeah, there's only two
there.
Ukrainian players left to do this, and just with the 10 seconds left. Vanessa goes down, and I think Rich is just trying to stay alive here.
Yeah,
maybe
Rich is
a better horse.
He was there early on, and he's there at the end, but he's
yeah,
not
and he'll have a lot of money now. He can sell that horse and buy up a big tanky one, probably in the next round, and that's going to maybe give him a chance here. He's still not buying a heavy horse here. He must be able to afford one, though. He's got 5 kills.
It's precisely because Rich can afford a good horse that he does not buy one, because he's smart with
money. I don't understand that.
He's smart with his money, man.
No, but they need better horses. It's just, I don't know.
He's got to save up for the nest egg for the.
Maybe he doesn't understand the money system, because he perhaps doesn't know that, like, you sort of, when you buy a higher tier item, you sell the other one. That's important. Anyway.
Lust. Looking at Bert's checkbook right here.
Well, you know, maybe he's just trying to save it for the last round. Because Ukraine came pretty close anyway. They could easily win this without him buying another horse. But I just think it would give him a bit of a better chance. Don't be too critical.
Ukraine's doing alright. It's actually really, really close right now.
But German cavalry punished them though there. Like, last round, Volsham got that really early headshot. And just put a massive stunt in the German cav force. Brought them down to two before the fight even started. Didn't manage to do the same thing this round. The German cav were a bit more cautious. And they did really nice work there. The Ukrainian cav shouldn't have challenged as much, I don't think. They should have waited for their teammates.
Max of Ukraine is up at the front, scouting out the enemy. Sees that the Germans are moving into the ruins. They're actually moving into different areas here. They own the forest and the ruins.
Yeah, they're spreading out, just making sure they can get to the flag early for a bit of raising. You see that on the minimap quite nice as well, that the Ukrainians are fairly contained. They're moving a little bit now between the castle wall and the small forest, but the Germans are way spread out, like, sort of all up their side of the
Germans
river around
so
on
nice
the bank.
Position that it makes it seem like this is orchestrated. Like, they got a plan here.
Yeah, I certainly would say that they do have a plan. Ukrainians are starting to spread out now. They're moving towards the bridge, gambling on a flag spawn up there, I think. If it doesn't spawn over there, then they're going to have a real hard time getting back over to the previous spawn point over behind the ruins. But the Germans are going to get there a lot faster.
The Germans are retreating, doubling back. It's the flag spawns way up on the hill.
Yeah, it's a nice flag spawn for them as well.
Now this is tough, though, because now they're separated men have to group back together. Flex is, I think he's coming in for a cheeky attack, yes.
Looks like Ukraine is going to sort of move at them.
I think the Ukrainians are splitting the Germans.
They're going to sort of charge at them through into their forest, it looks like.
If only the Ukrainians knew how disjointed the Germans are right now. Now the Germans finally got backup.
They've grouped up now, yeah.
Yes, I think they're pretty safe. The Ukrainians had a real good opportunity
The issue for the Ukrainians right now is Sphere, who's down by the wooden bridge. Bavendor is giving him under pressure.
Oh, beautiful shot. Vendetto up on the hill doing whatever he pleases.
Bavendor goes down as well pretty early on. That's gonna give Sphere a bit more freedom. He's going to come in right now and try and shoot in Ukrainians' backs. He could get a few kills here. Contest gets a kill here as well.
Vendetto's still up there.
Volsham takes down Chiari. Sphere's got to get in and try and do some damage here quickly, because in the fight, the Ukrainians are starting to dominate here. It's 5-on-5, and we've got some really low health Germans here right now. Contest is trying to go for both of them, but does get taken down by Nero.
Renekin
takes down Volsham at the same moment. 5-3 in favor of Germany right now.
Germany bringing it back. That was wonderful and absolutely crucial, those kills they got.
It is, but the Ukrainians, well, they've got to start. Someone's got to get on the flag now. There's only 30 seconds left.
Vendetto is getting ran off the flag. Now it's a Nero.
Flex takes down Renekin KB, but Vendetto's got to stay on the flag and stop the Germans from raising it.
Oh,
Flex
beautiful!
Comes in. Oh,
back up! Oh, he
knocks down
Nero,
but he fails the kill when he's on the ground. And in the meantime, Mark comes in and puts Vendetto out of business there. Sumrak goes down too. Flex is about to try and get a kill. Is it a bad, dodgy team kill by the Germans here? And he's 1-on-3. Flex, he's a beast of a player, but with 2 seconds left,
high
German flag.
One swing.
Down
Flex.
He goes, yeah. Poor guy. That's fair. Didn't get any. Don't think he got any actually shooting kills there, but he did come in to get a nice spear kill at the end, though. So fair play.
German is secure another round. Great job turning that fight down by the river.
Well, the problem is that Rich now couldn't have even afforded a big fancy horse, so that's a bit of a shame.
Rich is not playing to his name.
No, he certainly isn't. Well, perhaps it's just he was just trying to save the state. He just wants money, doesn't want, like, possessions. But to really be rich, what you need is a happy and healthy life.
Exactly. The man understands the true value of things.
Exactly. It's like the film Richie Rich, when they get into their special secret safe, and it's just like family crap and stuff.
Wait, really?
Yeah, do you not know that?
Are we talking about the feature crappy film?
Yeah, Richie Rich from Macaulay Culkin.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they get into their safe, and it's like they think it's going to be loads of money. The robbers get in there, and it's just like little family memories and things.
Were
It's
they
kind of sweet.
pissed and kind of like threw everything on the floor and stuff?
Yeah, they were furious because they wanted all the Richie Rich money. And Richie Rich didn't even have any money. Oh, they still had money, but it was just in the bank, and they're like, "Oh, okay."
Money in the bank. That's where Rich is. Oh, Rich is trying to get some money off a spear here. Trying to fill the coppers up with some blood.
Yeah, the Ukrainians have rushed in to try to take out
some blood money. Oh my god!
Oh, Rich, I'll take him down. The Ukrainian cav needs to scarper now, though, before the German cav come and harass them. They're coming in with their javs to try and take down the horses, but not much to getting them down so far.
Germans trying to get a retribution kill, but no, Rich and crew ride off with their.
Yeah, the Ukrainian cav's a little bit worse wear, but they'll be okay. Most of the arrows are kind of in the back of the horses, so they've probably been shot as they're riding away. Oh, except for Flex's horse, it looks a little bit roughed up, let's say. And those horses do go down easy, we know that.
Yep. Made of paper.
But I think it's still worth a kill for Sphere. Flex spawns in the same spot they did previously, up by the stone bridge.
Again, the Germans holding up in a little forested area. A little canopy of trees.
Yeah, Ukraine gonna hustle up there, try and get a bit of an attack going. In the meantime, the German cav is gonna come directly in the back of the Ukrainian team. They've noticed it and they're already shooting at them, so they're not gonna be able to do any sneaky attacking there. Avendir's had a really rough set, but I feel like positionally he's not been that bad. He's just not been able to get
Zeltanator
the kills.
And Nero trying to pressure the flag. Meanwhile,
Benetto getting another headshot there, and he's just been kind of getting a headshot every round or so far. He's been doing really nice work.
Oh my god, Ukraine take the forest canopy from behind the Germans. Now
they've got the
Germans
flag up a little bit higher as well, but Flex has gone down and
oh,
so
but
is
they're
Rich.
Doing a wonderful job at the center.
So Ukraine are really hard up for cav right now. They've only got Sumrak left to do a lot of work. Benedetto doing brilliant stuff
shooting,
with his
chain shooting, just
and
notching them and
Volshin
letting
kills
them go.
There as well. Germany, by focusing on the cav, have failed to address the Ukrainian archers who are doing some really nice work at the moment, but it's still 4-3 in favor.
Nero with a beautiful jab throw to finally shut down Benedetto.
Avendir goes down as well, and Volshin's got a big task ahead of him. He's been playing really well this set, but he's under a lot of pressure right now from this Mark and Rene KB. Does go down. Eventually, Simrak's going to go down too.
Ooh, wow.
Not without Germany getting another team kill. Oh, another team kill. Nero.
A lot of unnecessary deaths occurred right there.
There's some mutiny here, but Germany do take the round and the set 3-1 as we'll cut into a little break. But that's pretty good. They're going to be happy with that. Obviously, you can't be too disappointed if you're winning. The only issue, I think, is for Germany that Nords are really strong on this map. And, I mean, a lot of those rounds were really close. I think Ukraine could easily get 3-1. They might even be able to get 4-0. So,
you're saying that...
I'm saying that it's important, but yeah, they've really got to make sure that they kind of hold on to that lead in this round. Because I think Ukraine could easily do the same thing or even more as Nords.
So you're saying Germany has... They only got the slight edge because of the faction?
Because of the faction, yeah. So the swap now. With the swap now, we'll see what's really going on.
Well, and that was just amazing how the Nords... I mean, the Germans at the end were so resilient. They were down on that last fight, weren't they, at the beginning of it?
Yeah, but they did a good job targeting those Ukrainian cav and getting them down. I think the Ukrainian archers are doing really nice work, but without the cav support and with Germany just having the extra numbers on, the extra mounted numbers, they were just able to shut them down too quickly. I mean, field by the river is just a big field by a river, isn't it? So it's like, cav is going to be pretty important here.
Yes.
Once you get a lead there.
I am absolutely astonished by the resiliency of the German players.
You're astonished?
Yes. Astonished.
Are you taken aback or just astonished?
I am taken aback because...
Are you astounded or just astonished?
I'm pretty friggin' surprised.
would you say astounded though, or is that a step too far? Or is that less than astonished? I don't even know.
You have to pick the right word, my god. There's many synonyms, but it's so important to pick the right word for what you want to say.
Yeah. That's how you say things. You pick the word that you want to say, then you just say it.
No, it's about how you communicate clearly.
That's fair. In the meantime, we'll be seeing Germans go over to the Saren side.
I wonder how they will
Divide like cope with the different horses and the lack of jabs, because they were making good use of jabs there. We saw actually some nice jab kills even.
Oh, we saw some wonderful jab kills. Mendetta will tell you about a jab kill.
Dylan's really making good use of it, yeah.
Suffers.
Yeah, Bendetto. But Bendetto was doing nice work anyway.
Oh, yes. He was shooting away. But I noticed the Ukrainian archers, it always would devolve. The big ruckus would happen, and then all that would be left were the unfortunate Ukrainian archers. Without any support.
Just poor Ukrainian archers.
Just standing well, on their leg.
They were doing great, so... hopefully they'll, hopefully they'll be able to do the same sort of thing as Nords. And gives it a close match here. I think the Ukrainian cav was really good though as well. I just think Rich is going to be regretting not trying to go for that heavy horse, even if he takes like less armor or something like that. Just hold your shield up, avoid the archers, and just like bump everything you can see. He probably could have had a nice round there. I feel like the Germans, even if they're not playing as well as the Ukrainians, I mean certainly their archers weren't looking too hot, whereas they normally are, like Chirai, etc. You know, if the archers aren't looking too hot, they're generally making very good buy decisions and tactical choices.
Except
with
for
regards
Rich.
To the flag as well.
Not getting that horse.
Who, not getting that horse? No, I'm saying the Germans are making the good decisions.
Oh, the Germans, yes, they are. I like how they split up and then regroup. They focus on dominating.
I think we're live. We are live now, right now, so...
Live on restart, therefore live... No.
We're live now, it's restarted.
Alright, factions have switched. We are going to get right back in here.
Go, Johnny, go.
Go, Johnny, go.
And, yeah, same sort of setups. Germany, doing actually what you... Oh, Germany actually taking 4 cav now. Addressing the sort of insufficiency in the Sarnid's team and, the sort of paper cav, and they're going to go for 4 of them instead of 3. Yeah, quite interesting.
If
I quite like 4 cav.
I've seen this before. Someone went to my high school. Some big old burly man and ripped a phone book in front of people, and I was like, wow.
and explain the relevance of that.
The relevance being, if you stack the paper, it gets harder to rip. You know what I'm saying? Because it looked, yeah, try ripping a phone book. Look, I got paper right in front of me, a little notebook. You can't rip that.
Yes, but the issue is, are you Crane a big burly man?
I don't know. I think there was some.
Because
if you crane
or a big burly man, then Germany got some issues there. Because no matter how much you stack, a big burly man is sure to rip right through you.
Yes. I have bears in my mind.
Yes, bear forces. It does leave Germany with a. Only 2 infantry and 2 archers.
But they got all that
just
paper,
just 2 archers for Ukraine as well, but Ukraine got for extra infantry this time.
They got the paper.
It's like Sonic is coming. I don't know who dropped out. Oh, I think Avon did drop out. He had a bit of a rough set.
Flag in the corner. Now comes a mad dash from both teams to see who gets there first and who gets the advantage. The positional advantage from getting there first.
Put right Germany, now, I think, a little bit closer. But Germany have, like... an archer left over in the field by the castle.
Ukraine's just running right across the water's edge here.
Yeah, they are, and they've got a lot of German cav to deal with very soon, and they don't want to move in it. They don't want to move separately because Bendetto here, especially.
Oh, there's fights happening on the back line though.
Bendetto here has really got no support, and if the other German cav come in to try and take him down, he could have a really hard time here.
This
he's
looks
doing
like
his best
some
to fight
mass
out.
Exodus of refugees. What is happening here?
Volshin's
no,
supporting
fighting.
Him. Volshin's supporting
running.
Him as well, but. With Volshin supporting him, it means that he's isolated too, and he's not supporting his other teammates over by the flag. And I think Germany, with these extra cav, just taking map control, and they just split up Crane far too much here. But Bendetto and Volshin, I mean, they got to go over and support their teammates. Look at this right now. Germany have almost raised the flag. No one's died yet in the round, which is insane.
Oh,
let's get the first kill.
Ukraine are now all amassed together at the flag, though, with that Nord strain.
But I mean, Ukraine have got to just—they got to push things forward now because they got the lower flag. They've just got to start getting kills. Sonic gets a kill. Samrak takes out the Zeltonator. Warringham gets a nice double kill here, coming in, killing 2 of the Ukrainian players. Does go down there in the end, and Ukraine I think are going to snowball it through, but they've just got to make sure they get all the flag pretty soon. Killer could come in and do like a quick dismount.
Perhaps there could be something here.
Renekton does go down. But the thing is, well, Yona's too far away to do anything now. He's range dueling with Volshin has rendered himself pretty redundant. Quite bad by Yona, really. But his killer's gonna try and dismount and he gets the flag in time. He's not gonna do it. And yeah, he looks like Ukraine did manage to get all the Germans. They managed to clean the flag of Germans, and
they sanctified the soil around the flag.
And raised the flag, yeah. So well played by Ukraine there. A bit touch and go, but they have a bit of extra gold now, a little bit of extra gear.
And, I like what you mentioned, the observation you said, Lust, that the Germans were doing their best to try to dominate the field with the cav while both teams were trying to get it there. I think the problem was the Germans didn't really get anyone or pick anyone off before the big old ball.
Yeah, you're right. It was mad how they didn't even take down Benetto. Benetto didn't even die, and they had two cav like really working him. Voshin didn't go down either. So it's great sort of individual play from them to be able to sort of hold out against that pressure, but you sort of feel like the burden should be on the cav to actually make those players go down. You can force it if you with the bump slashing and bump lancing. Perhaps I think technically the German cav are not quite as talented as they could be. They're missing sort of some of those technical skills like bump lancing and bump slashing that could have served them really well though.
They're technically deficient. I love how you sugarcoat it, Lust.
No, but it's technical skills. Like,
they unskilled.
I mean, you separate it because, I mean, positionally they're fine and they're making good decisions. They were splitting up the German team really well just by the way they were moving and the way they're acting. But like the technical ability to actually like get those hits off and get those kills is really important. And like the best cav in the scene right now are getting bump slashes and bump lances with really sort of high reliability. And you got to be able to do that too if you want to compete, I think. Great work from Ukraine.
The difference between skill and luck, consistency.
It's not to take away from Benedetto or Volshin's achievements, though. It's hard to hold off in any situation against a cap like that.
It's hard to hold off a big old group of Nords. But yeah. I see what you're saying, though. It is crucial for them to have that individual skill to catch the people and couch them correctly.
Indeed. Oh, yeah.
And then, of course, you always just blame the lags. So.
Blame that lag. Well, you can't really blame the lag if you're Germans playing on a French server. They got one player
that's,
over like
that's
60
a
ping.
Throw away.
They got two players over 50 ping, so it's not bad.
Not bad at all, and Ukraine like their chances on this flag because they're moving the brunt of their force up there. Nero and Zeltanator already there trying to defend.
Germans can be there slightly faster, but Zeltanator loses his shield or like immediately there.
Yes, Rich gets the man's shield, but the man lives though.
I think he ate a javelin, but didn't really take any damage from it. It's weird.
Hit his armor just in the right spot. Zeltanator getting a little peppered.
Germany pretty comfortable on the flag, but Ukraine is sort of... Ukraine kind of coming to surround them a little bit here.
Yona's a little bit further back. Surrounding them up on the hill, but the
Germans got their eyes in night vision. Yeah, Triari and Yona are in quite night visions here. Benetto finally comes in to sort of distract Yona, and the Germans are losing players as well. Flex doing great work this round on his horse.
Wow,
getting a third kill here, bring down
Rani
KP as well.
Engagements.
And I think the Ukrainian cav is the real story to tell here. They've just been a little bit stronger than the Germans throughout.
Triari's getting some good shots.
Triari is doing nice work, yeah, but he's going to be under pressure now. He's not going to be able to fire at all.
Oh,
actually, got to go down there to I-poop. Or le-poop. Or poop.
Le-poop.
Le-poop. Like the French. Like a French poo. And wonderful play from Ukraine. Already getting up to already getting up to 3-3, and this could be a 4-0 for the Ukraine now, and that would be a real blow to Germany. It felt so good starting off.
I loved how Ukrainians took that flag. They moved up as a group. They took the high ground, and then
they sent players round one and one to take out the archers. Well, I quite like the fact that they sent their archers to take out the enemy archers. It meant that. It meant that they had sort of strength in the infantry fight still, and they could run the infantry properly.
Yep.
And normally you'll kind of have your archers kiting, and your infantry will try and take down their archers. But I like the way that Ukraine played that, and they had Benetto just kind of going around.
They did play that.
Knocking all the archers off their posts. Very nice.
Neutralizing the threats early, and then going for the kill at the center.
Exactly. It was great play from Flex as well. Looking like a really solid cav there.
Your prediction's coming through. Maybe without that Nord advantage here, the Germans are at a loss for what to do.
They might be having a bit of a rough time. But I wouldn't rule them out at all yet.
The score is tied, right? It is 3-3.
3-3?
Yes.
Two rounds left to play in this set. Yeah, I mean, I thought this seems to be very close. I think... I'm not sure... But I should be sure. But I think they both got, like...
Slightly confident.
They both either got, like, 12-4 or 11-5 against Scandinavia. So they were quite roundly trounced, really, by Scandinavia. But they got similar scores in the end. I think... that's right, yeah, sorry. Scandinavia got 11-5 against Ukraine. And 12-4 against Germany. So Ukraine did a little bit better, but not too much. And just sort of according to the maps and things like that, that can change anyway. So you can't read too much into it.
Map is split completely in half here. So this doesn't seem like much happens because there's a standstill and both sides look at each other. There's actually small little skirmishes to take territory.
That's played by the ruins now, and Ukraine have not made any movement towards it at all. Germany could get there really fast.
Germany's already set up Yona.
They're making Germany making a big rush for the flag right now. Yona has not waited over too close to the flag this time as well.
UK are running as one big group, but how high is that flag? I think it might be way too high. I think now Germany are just going to manpile the flag here.
Yeah.
For win.
I think Ukraine going to have a hard time getting to the flag
across
race.
Not as Sumo has anything to say with this, or Sumray.
They're stacking up on it, and there's really not much time left. Ukraine just, they were just sitting too far away from where that flag had spawned, and it's just...
It's not over yet. It's unfortunate
they're gonna win without really getting a fight.
They gotta get there real quick. That flag is going.
They're not gonna make it.
It's
going.
Sumrak, someone.
I think Sumrak's gonna dismount. I think he can dismount.
Spam the Kappas.
But he could go down really fast now, and that's not really done much. And in the meantime, the Germans are just cutting through them.
Oh, and they win. That reached the tippy top.
No, it was silly from Ukraine to just sit in that big forest. It's so far away from this flag, and they didn't really. They sort of deserve that for being so passive. they'll be gutted, and they'll probably be blaming the map right now. But that was their
own fault. The map spawn did play a huge faction in it. But if you look at what actually happened there, those tiny skirmishes at the beginning, where the teams are trying to establish
the issue is that Ukrainians probably. I'm guessing a lot of what the Ukrainians are thinking right now, but maybe they think something completely different. But I mean, this is something that a lot of teams do. So I don't want to pick on Ukraine particularly. But yeah, here we go. Yeah, as I guessed, they're pretty angry with Phil by the river. But it's unrealistic to think that you have the right to just sit in that big forest and wait for the flag. Like that's not a legitimate tactic because you can get punished by what Germany just did there. It's no one's fault.
Here's
but Ukraine.
The thing though, Ukraine did send a few horsemen out by the ruins to try to get a foothold of that area, but Germany deeply entrenched there.
I don't know. Look, I'm not a big fan of this map, but teams can't just feel like they have the right to just sit in that big forest and then get a fight. Like,
no one knows anything, Ukraine. You ain't got no right to nothing.
They could send players to the ruins. They could do lots of different things.
Gotta earn your flag.
Chance when that flag is spawned, and they're just blaming the map, which I think is a bit. I don't want to criticize the teams, but they don't have a right to do that. Even though I don't think the map is great either. I'm very critical. I'm criticizing everything in this situation.
What is your problem with the map?
Well, I sort of agree that the flag spawn is too. Is the flag spawn is too far away?
Just
it's not
way
in balance.
Too far.
Yeah, it's just it's. Like, it does hinge a lot on that. But
the,
I mean,
the fights
team...
kind of happen as you're running. You're kind of running next to the guys, slicing each other while you're all running, like, going head first to the flag.
It's like the flag is the random factor that no one likes, and you're just making the random factor that no one likes, like, the most important factor. That's why I don't like it. It's inherently not kind of right. But at the same time, like, play the map. At least, you know it's there. You know that can happen, or you should know that can happen. If you don't, then that's just no one's fault.
Well,
your
I
own.
Think Ukraine are now responding
Germany,
to it.
Germany have backed off. And the team's very close right now. Ukraine could go for the flag now. They're actually are closer, but not very much, not really that much closer. And if they back off too much, like Bendetto's backing off really far right now.
Ukraine
not
does not
want to
give up this forest. First kill.
I'm really concerned about Ukraine right now because they have got like not much support at all here.
Great
a lot
job,
of their players
bro.
Have backed off. And Germany moving into them as a unified group. They're going to be relying on the cav here. Flex gets caught.
Oh, Zeltanator all up in the center of him. He dies, but he does some great damage on Vulcan.
It's 6-on-6 right now. It's really close. And Ukraine actually have a player who's a little bit too far away right now. Yona's over in the forest. Very, very close round. Oh, and a great two kills there by Germany. Killer takes down Vulcan. Renekton B takes down Sonic, and Germany taking a small advantage here.
Rich going after Yona, I think it was able to disrupt him a little.
A crucial round, because if Germany can win this, then they'll take actually the advantage going into the second map. They are four players against three. There's 1 minute left. No one's gone anywhere near the flags yet.
Captain
Yona,
Renek doing his best to keep Yona alive.
Yona's actually proved crucial in this round. They're just peppering the Ukraine players. Flex is still alive, and so is iPoop.
Flex is a little disgruntled that his attempts to kill Yona didn't work out.
iPoop is barely alive, but Renek KB comes in with a reckless charge. And iPoop is able to dismount him.
I didn't realize.
It was Alpoop. Flex gets right up there though, and Alpoop doing great work there. Trying to keep saying this, but he's just got such little health.
Oh,
Flex goes down.
Beautiful kill on Flex.
And Alpoop goes down too to Killer. So great work from the German team there. Ukraine, going to be pretty frustrated at the map, but at the same time, I don't think they have much of a right to be. Last time, maybe you think that they have a right to be, maybe you think they got really hard done by. Or, you know, maybe whatever you think, just tweet in, let us know.
Are we on break?
We're on a break right now.
Oh my god, we are on a break.
Just for the second map.
There we go. An exciting match so far. Absolutely in favor of Germany right now, though.
Yeah, it was 5-3 in favor of Germany. Anything can happen, and I think Ukraine might prefer the closed map, where they can get the infantry going a little bit more. It's Mountain Fortress, which was
a more exciting map, a more personal one.
It was a mixed map, and then it might even have been an open map at one point, but now it's a closed map.
It got reclassified?
They sort of changed it. I think it was mixed. I think it was mixed, and they changed it and added a bunch of extra stuff outside. So now it's like pretty much a closed map, but it's kind of like there's like open bits, but it's basically a closed map, really.
That is awesome.
It's still quite large, though, as maps go. There's a big old bridge as you run into it.
Well, talking about what happened in the previous map, the Germans were able to do well without having the guards.
That's completely true, but I think it was more sort of easily punishable errors from the Ukraine there. I wouldn't rule out the Ukrainians from this game at all yet. I make sure the minimap's set up right, by the way. It won't be automatic, this one.
Oh no, I switched it. I got practice.
Minimap, which is beautiful. It's gonna be Roblox versus Swider as well. So lots of crossbows, and we know who likes crossbows, which is Bendetto. So watch out for that. This guy on this map, Bendetto, is an absolute. He's a brilliant crossbow, and Vulture's been playing really well as well. I think Triari and Yona sort of came in throwing a little bit more as Nords, but overall, I've been liking the look of the Ukrainian archers today. What are you giggling at now?
I don't know. Like, I'm sorry, but if we ever became a real esport, I think there's tournament rule. Are there tournament bylaws that you can't like name yourself like I poop? You know?
It's L poop. It's L poop.
I think it's an I, my friend.
Yeah, maybe it's an I. I don't know.
That's a wonderful children's story, though. Everyone.
No, there are silly names like that. I think.
I like it. I'm sorry, I was just giggling about that. I know, it's like middle school humor, but dang it, he got me.
Okay. I think middle school is perhaps a little bit of an overstatement.
You're right. We're talking way back when we're mixing like our chocolate milks with the strawberry milks on our plates level. Like, yeah.
Oh, you mixed chocolate and strawberry milk?
I mixed everything. I threw some ketchup in there.
That's disgusting.
Yes, it was all disposable. It was all disposable. I did bad things as a child.
Bad things?
Well,
you're the tough history as a child.
Nonetheless, at least I got my milk and I drank it. Strong bones.
Did you mix your milk and ketchup, and then did you go to a scared straight program where like people from the prison came and like scared you and said, if you mix your milk,
yeah, those are the guys.
Every day,
those are
if
the
you
guys
mix your milk every day,
phone
you're gonna end up like me in prison. You're gonna be mixing soap and I don't know.
Those are the guys that came and ripped the phone book.
I don't know what people say in prison.
That is exactly how he started it. He was saying that.
Oh, wait, was he a scared straight guy?
Yes, a scared straight guy. And he said, if you end up in prison, this is you. And then he just rips the phone book.
The thing about scared straight, it sounds like they've like intimidated a homosexual to like change to a straight person. You know what I mean?
Really?
Like scared straight.
I don't know. Psychologically scaring people into compliance is the best way to get them to do things. But, hey, I'm drug free.
It works for many, man, because you're
going to
jail.
I'm not in prison. I'm drug free. So, hey.
So they know what they're doing.
They know what they're doing.
He stopped mixing his milk. So,
And I think the Germans know what they're doing here because they are a team killing away, trying to get ready here. Just getting.
This is a pretty big map. Like, I'm looking around it now. It's pretty huge. You got like a big back alley.
This map's glorious, and in a few moments you guys will see it in all its glory as we float the camera around and do the awesome intros that Lust so graciously provides for us.
I hope you enjoy the intros and the minimap as well.
Yes.
For the time being, though, it's going to be Ukraine starting Aswadia. Germany going to kick off as Rodox. I don't know who I like more. I think I probably like Rodox more because of miniature cleavers, but Aswadia are kind of dirty. Like, Aswadia right now, everyone says that they're really snowball-y, so like when they start winning, they really win a lot. And it can be the case, but we see a lot of times where that isn't the case as well, so it's hard to just like make a blanket rule. But definitely Aswadia, you can get your mail going, get your armor going really quickly. So the first couple rounds of the set are really important. It's going to be important that Germany
loses the first few rounds.
The worst thing is if you lose the rounds, but like you lose them really decisively. If you lose them, but you get like most of their players out, like 6 or 7 or something like that, then you're doing okay.
It's going to be live on restart, according to Foam, so I'm going to run the intro.
Hit it.
Hit that bad boy. And we are in the game!
Mountain Fortress by Thunderon.
Mountain Fortress, yes, by the wonderful Thunderon.
Great map, I like it. I kind of didn't really get it at first, but I like the new version with the kind of closed outside. It's charmed me, let's say that much. An interesting play by Ukraine, they've kind of rushed straight in with Aswadia.
Yep, they are boldly taking that village. 4 cap
for both teams, 2 cap for both teams, 2 arches for both teams, also crossbows, pretty standard. Ukraine into the village straight away, so the match, they've already kind of swapped places. Ukraine gonna go into, like,
wow, they're going all the way to the spawn. This
German
is a new
spawn,
Subrak,
yeah.
Boldly stepping foot where no man has stepped before, into the spawn of his enemies.
Or is he just lost?
I don't know, he's wandering over there, because the enemy has come, I think they've utterly swapped, have they not? Yes.
Well, the Ukrainian team is still kind of, well, the German team, sorry, is still kind of, hanging out by like the table.
Yep,
the table,
apple that table.
Yeah. Well, there's actually more apples now though. Oh no, there's one stool, that was the point, yeah.
No, there was always one chair, so it was always one
stool. Yeah, one stool, yeah.
By himself.
Lonely apple table.
That's how I figure, he just sits there and chops off a piece and munches and thinks, man, I wish someone was sitting with me. And then he fights another piece. It's pretty lonely out here.
Yeah. Apple is such a lonely fruit, I don't know. He's chomping away on his apple. At least with like a Satsuma, you get the skin stays and you're like a little. Like, but you got the core with an apple. You can keep the core as your friend afterwards.
That is very.
But like, there's some fruit that you just kind of eat it all, and it's like you have nothing left.
You can put the little googly eyes on them, but nonetheless, the flag has spawned Germany in a wonderful position.
Wait, let me just say, if you put googly eyes on your apples, make sure it's not like, make sure it's like edible glue. You don't want to get like glue with like chemicals in it and then eat it. Like, just be careful of that.
That's just for snuffing.
Yeah. But don't half glow, that's bad. Anyway, Germany on the flag, really early on, they're going to raise it. Germany's just the flag trolls this map. But Ukraine have got to wake up, they've got to get on the flag and start pressuring Ukraine.
Ukraine got there really quickly, quickly enough that I think Germany didn't have proper time to set up. Renek is doing some interference.
Well, I think they spent too much time flag trolling and not a lot of time.
Bendetto, good shot
up,
in the back.
Yeah, that's troubling.
Ukrainians, Sonic just kind of, in the midst of all
they're
the
charging
Germans.
Into. Pretty much a meat grinder right now. Flex does pull a kill back and is moving around trying to get something done, but taking out my Yona there, and Yona is pretty much unchallenged at that point. In a really great position here, just by that wall.
Wow, did Ukraine just throw themselves to their deaths? Sumrak!
He slid in the enemy spawn. No, he's over by this kind of back entrance area, so I guess.
Oh, did Volshin get cornered?
Oh, it's Volshin.
This is sad.
It's Volshin.
This is sad. He's toying with him. Mark is toying with Volshin here in the corner.
But, yeah, he says the corner's bump Lance as well.
Oh,
Volshin could
try
and get his horse
even
down.
Even a cornered bunny rabbit will fight back.
Volshin should swing and try and get that horse down. He's gonna die like this.
Oh,
that's
God.
Kick and,
he
Germany
may have been trampled
the
there, among other things.
Germany take a 6-3 lead. You gotta say, I think Rodox will be a stronger faction on this map, but Ukraine have to win at least one round here, or Germany are going to take take the win
what is the
on this
proper
set.
Score, Lust?
It's 6-3, yeah.
6-3, there we go.
Sorry, the score locking in the admin mod is kind of not working right now.
It doesn't work always, but we fix it. But,
Is Shema saying you can eat a whole apple? Like, and the core?
Oh, you can? That's disgusting.
Don't eat an apple core. Because then you got apple seeds growing out your nose and your ears and stuff. And...
But, Ukraine really boldly, they charged Germany and tried to...
Do we have an AFK? No, it's not AFK. Mark being kind of silly.
Mark being absolutely silly, but...
Being a silly Billy.
What was reproachable about Ukraine's charge? Because it was highly ineffective.
It's hard to say. They just...
Well, they
they kind of clumped up a bit too much. They could have... I think the Cav kind of weren't really there when they need to be, necessarily. I don't know, it is hard because Rodox should be winning melee fights against Swadians anyway, especially in the first round. But it's hard to say that they, like, failed, although they did fail really badly.
Nice from Bullshit.
I think that's what really what a team like that needs, to get a nice little boost like that at the start of the round, if something happens. I guess what I'd like to see from Ukraine is... Perhaps maybe they should have slowed it down, tried to shoot a little bit more, put the Germans under a little bit more pressure. The issue was that the Germans had the flag, so they kind of felt the pressure to charge in there. Maybe they should have waited a little bit more.
Yeah, they felt their options were taken from them on that.
Well, they were limited. I suppose it was well played by the Germans. And the Germans, they actually split off from the flag at the end. They weren't really raising it too hard, and they got themselves set up decently by the end of it.
Oh, flag spawns in a novel position.
Yeah,
over here by the bucket. This is so rare. I've rarely seen this.
Up by where the Ukrainians start. It's got sort of got an axe.
Chopping
wood.
Oh, God. What's in the basket? What's in the box?
Oh,
what's in the box, Morgan Freeman? What's in the box?
Morgan Freeman hiding his boxes. Weird guy. Okay.
It's a 7.
There's a fight broken out on the flag now. Miniature cleavers against Gambazons. Tough times. Volshin with another kill in this round, making himself useful. Renekton P does come back and bring Sonic down. That's going to be a nice kill for them. There's lots of action going on the flag though. Rich comes in with a couch stance, doesn't actually manage to get too much done there. Rich
wonderful
desperately trying to, desperately trying to do something for his team.
Right at the axe position.
Ipoop takes on Yona, Killer on, takes on Ipoop. Volshin and Flex with kills here to bring down Warringham. Zeltonator, Bidette comes in as well and...
Ukrainian are completely. Oh my god.
Yeah, they're dominating now. I think now that it's sort of gone a little bit slower, I think Ukraine did a lot better. They didn't really feel any pressure because the flag wasn't high. And with it just being a little bit slower, they had their time for their archers to do a bit more work. Which I think is where they're. Looking a bit stronger than Germany at the moment.
Dropping the axe on people from his position there. Wonderful.
But what Ukraine really going to want to do right now is win both of these rounds. They're going to want to try and get perhaps some mail armor now right now. They had a lot of players stay alive then. Yeah, they've got a lot of players getting mail armor. It's going to be hard for the Rodox to deal with that. Germany.
Has the snowball started rolling down the hill? It's gaining traction.
It's started rolling. It's not like...
It's not huge. It ain't going to demolish a town yet. But.
It's right now it's like the size of like the bottom of a snowman. It's not, like, if they win this round, then it might be like, you know, in the cartoons, like, where you have, like, a person, and you just see their arms and their legs and their head sticking out the snowboard, and they're just spinning around, and it's getting bigger and bigger. Like, if they win this round, then they'll be like that. But, not yet.
Ukraine looking to drop an avalanche on the Germans. But, it's not happening yet, but the Ukrainian are playing a
strong... Okay, I gotta tell you this. I played a board game yesterday.
Yes.
And it was about, like, climbing up... K2, the second tallest mountain in the world. And it was like weird.
Game about that?
Yeah. And I tell you what, it was cool. I loved it.
Really?
It
there's
so good.
Some
yeah,
novel
yeah,
board
yeah.
games.
Yeah, lots of board game fans in the office, and it was like so fun. Anyway.
My friend
pretty
my
pretty even
is
so
that
far.
Island one.
I don't know what that is.
Settlers of Catan. You should get that, it's very good.
I've heard of it. I think they play that as well sometimes. Anyway.
Oh, anyway,
ooh,
indeed,
Nero.
I really
sat this guy's like, anyway, boom.
Boom, headshot. Oh, Rich came from the back. Flex is also running in from the back. What is this?
Ukrainian
attack.
That's a little bit risky. Yeah, they didn't
get they didn't
there.
Really like the Germans.
But the important, the key thing to note is that Benedetto took down an enemy horseman. And that's oh no, it wasn't a horseman.
German but, so, on the defensive. This is bad. This is how Ukrainian did the Germans won the last round.
I think the Germans lost a horse. Yeah, Mark lost his horse.
Ukrainians already setting the pace for last round. They are getting the first kill early. Oh! Fortunate Germans timing flag. For German!
Germans on the flag first, so Ukraine, they got to get in there. And we know that Ukraine don't like to feel pressured by the flag, so they might make a little bit of a hasty rush here. German archers are going to spread themselves out a little bit here.
Oh, what a nice great shot before Flex could do anything!
And that's really punishing.
His horse
as well.
Is even jamming the attack by Ukraine.
Oh, but Troy does go down as well, and Benedetto, I told you, this guy on a closed map with a crossbow loves his job.
Oh my god, Yoda's going down soon, wonderful Max, shot by Yoda!
Benedetto is forced to come into the melee right now because it's going so fast, and this is not what Germany, it's not what Ukraine want. Ukraine don't want a fast round, they want it slow. They perhaps could have backed off a little bit more, the flag's not too high, they
nice
stay
and
back.
Slow, but they're getting it fast and hard. Kappa fighting off two men, Renek going around getting more people.
Oh, and Yoda is just doing beautiful
Yoda's
work
here. Yoda's doing such great work! The Germans bringing the round back!
An absolute brilliant crossbowman in the heat of the battle. He's getting all the hits right when he needs to
get
them.
Oh my god, Wunderbar!
And a fantastic round from Germany. But I think Ukraine, again, like, they didn't need to take it that fast. They could have sat back. It's hard to sort of make that decision when you've only got two crossbowmen. It's hard to sort of trust yourself to think, well, there's, you know, eight of us here. Why are we going to rush in now? You know, or why are we going to wait here while six of us are doing basically nothing and just let our crossbows do like, work? It kind of feels like a stupid decision. In a way, it kind of can be. I guess what you sort of need to do is maybe have your infantry go forward, but not really engage and things like that. I just think that when the fight is going that fast, Germany just looking stronger in the melee fights, and it's Ukraine had to slow it down, and they didn't manage to do it there.
Ukraine did what they did before; they picked off a man. Everyone's getting water from the troughs, or they're using them kind of like in stadiums where you just kind of all huddle together and pee in a bucket. But
no, we didn't do that.
Did I poop there?
I poop.
But
I poop, I'm sure poop's in the toilet.
Ukraine, I'm sure he misses with a name like that. That's why he has the name! People call him that! Because
he misses
himself. He poops himself.
I suppose that is missing the toilet if you poop yourself. It's missing it by a really long way.
Nonetheless,
0 points.
Ukraine,
0 points of pooping
I think
in your own
pants. Charge ended right when that guy on the horse got stopped. His horse jammed the assault. It just all fell apart from that beautiful headshot. Right on down. I'm not sure who was killed. Was it Ritz that died on the horse there?
That was Flex died first. And it was a great shot from Yona.
Flex died first.
Yona just looking really nice. It's a much big improvement over the last map where I don't think Yona was doing all that much work. It was perhaps being a bit too passive, not really getting involved when he needed to. But really brilliant in these sort of close quarters fights where you just gotta, like, the shots are not even hard to get because they're generally very close, but it's just about getting them consistently
not
and getting the timing. Well, it's hard. They're hard, not like hard in sort of in the aim, but it's
armchair playing at its finest right here.
It is, but the difficulty is the timing and the decision making, which Yona is clearly very competent at. So I'm giving lots of credit there. Fights went outside, and Ukraine are trying to get there first. But it's perhaps a little bit close to Germany. They're going to slip down by the side of this bridge. They're going to be a little bit close to the flag, so
here by the basket.
By that sort of executioner's block. A few little benches where people watch the executions. So the fight's kind of going on the top of this little slope.
Yes, the
another
fight
team, another team
right
wants to go down. Yeah, they still want to avoid the enemy cav, both teams. That's what the infantry are trying to do anyway.
Flex running into Rich.
Yeah.
Not too much loss from that, though. They lost their attack because then they got to get.
Well, Rich normally plays cav with a player called Shawnee Baron.
Oh, wow. Rich is doing such beautiful disruption work, though. It seems like Germany's cav are too busy trying to chase Flex and Rich and not assisting in the melees.
And Ukraine have done really brilliant work in the melee there. As it just slowed down a little bit more, Sumrak especially is really torn them apart.
Wow.
They're very nice there. And you see, Yona, this is referring to his sort of old map ways and the ways that he was playing in Field with the River, where he's just basically not there where he needed to be. He's still got full health. He's nowhere near any of his teammates. And they just lost already without him. And he can't turn it around now.
And that was about as close, even a fight as you can get. Both factions were right there at the center. They had their cav, their infantry.
But Yona's clearly just not where he needs to be, not where he needs to be. And Warband is a game of engagements. I explained this a little bit to the guy I was chatting with on Reddit. It's a game of engagement. Make sure that when the engagements happen, you've got everyone as supported as they can be and supporting as much as they can be.
Yona can fight with a sword, not for long, but he knows how.
Down he goes, and he had a great set, but you're not useful to your team being killed by 7 people at the end of the round there. So, fair play, it's still a game. 7-5 to
still
Germany
very close
as we go into
very
the third break.
Game.
Yeah.
Ukrainian Cav was just stupendous that round.
I would agree. Yeah,
they knew how to be useful in utility, not in kills, but in utility.
They were stupendous after they ran into each other at the start of the round.
Oh, yeah. Well, then again, Germany didn't capitalize on that.
That's true.
I think a few of the infantry, when that happened, a few of the German infantry really started pushing hard and getting some stabs in, but then the horses regrouped.
Yeah, they did indeed. And, it's good play by Ukraine there. They managed to keep it at least to a 2-2 in that set.
So now how does this work? Is it 1-9 wins, right? Or...
1-9, well, it's best out of 16, basically. And if it's even after that, then you know what happens. You know where we're going.
Oh, I know what happens. The duels. The soccer shootouts.
It's not the duels.
Oh,
you don't know what happens.
What does? Oh, well, is it that crazy map?
The tiebreaker map, the crazy map.
Oh, the weird map.
Crazy
is that snow
map.
One?
No, it's the other one. It's Proving Grounds. It's symmetrical.
Was it a snow map?
No, this week is not a snow map, but I don't know why because. I don't know why because.
Who gets their jollies making these perfectly symmetrical maps?
That is A. Azan. All credit to the guy. He made them for like a specific tournament.
Well, credit goes to him, but it might not be too hard because you only got to make half a map and then you just kind of flip it.
it's not as hard. There's no flip button though in the Warband editor, so it's, you know. You have to make sure that it's all precise and fair and even and eastboardy.
You're right, I actually have messed with the editor. It is rather hard to get stuff situated. It's a bit unwieldy. Much props to map makers.
But the issue is that it's still pretty abstract anyway. Like the idea of doing it is that you're still playing a match.
The idea is abstract.
But it's not fully formed.
It's nebulous like a cloud.
Well, the idea is that you're still playing a match instead of doing like something like dueling, which is like nothing to do with like normal Warband play or battle mode. But the thing is though, it's battle mode, but it's like everyone. Like on Winterberg, it's like everyone taking infantry on like this crazy tiny map that is nothing like any of the other maps. That's like totally symmetrical, which is nothing like any of the other maps either. So it's like it's just weird that
it's closer to the real thing.
It's closer, but
there.
It's still not even
still
really
fake.
Close anyway.
Still fake.
And the thing is, like at least if you do duels,
is
then people
live,
can practice. I think it's live, yeah.
Okay.
The thing is, at least if you do duels, people can practice it. Like you can practice duels all day. It's like a penalty in like soccer, you know, soccer or football.
Football. Gotcha.
Well, it's no soccer.
I'm calling it by the term you're familiar with.
Football. Yeah. Do you know penalties? Penalty shootout.
Penalties. Yeah. Red cards. Yellow cards.
You know penalty? Do you know what a penalty shootout? No. Like a penalty shootout.
Yeah.
Like when they kick the ball, like.
Word. I know. I watch soccer.
Okay. Yeah. It's like that. It's that. Like. It's not really what soccer is. It's like kind of the same kind of thing ish, but not really the same.
Well, if you really want to do penalty shootouts in Warband, you should do duels. But nonetheless,
that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying.
That's what I'm pushing for. People get
because
on
the thing is, like penalties work because you can practice penalties and it makes sense. Like it's like saying like, oh, if it's a draw after full time, extra time in football, you should just go, oh well, let's play on a really tiny pitch with 3 balls or something like that. It's kind of like saying that.
Like, yeah, it is like
it's closer to real football than I guess like a penalty shootout, but it's still you can't really practice it very much. And
it's
like, weird. And it's still totally different. So that's kind of that's the analogy I'd use. But I think it's still fun and it still works anyway. Like it's still kind of cool.
It is kind of neat. And at least you have a resolution for ties.
Exactly. Yeah.
Nonetheless, y'all should see the Americans in their duels because duels are awesome.
I think duels will be fun, but
No duels happening here.
You can tweet us and let us know what you think of duels. You probably all hate them because you're probably players and kind of hard. Apparently, eating apple core is actually healthy and it tastes good.
I poop is holding off all these men down this hallway. I think some cab tars now.
Someone is recommending the wheat apple cores on Twitter, and I just disagree, because you get the weird hard bits around the seeds and stuff, and ooh.
Then again, it could be the healthiest part of the apple, then again, all the sugars, but kind of like broccoli, where it's better to eat the...
Dork.
Not the floor.
Oh, brilliant shot by Volshin there, fantastic. They stun killer immediately. The guy was swinging randomly, just like trying to faint and stuff, and Volshin just punished him. It was beautiful. Germany coming in from two directions here, and I think it's a nice way to approach this flag.
Yes,
Ukraine got it pretty high, but it's going to be pointless now because this is going to be resolved by the fight. In any case, Ukraine are ahead now, 8 players to 6.
Sumac
and Volshin getting kills here as well, but Germany putting some stuff back. Yona loves to be in a situation with this fast going fight.
Yona's just
running away right now. As Rich is just
Tiari getting chained up against the fence.
And Yona warring him. Got last players left.
Warring ham. He needs to go real ham right now to kill all these men. Oh, Sheriff, he's doing it so well.
That's a bit of greed from Vendetta. They wanted to kill, and he's now on -1 alive. But Ukraine get around in any case. Sumrak is going to be pretty angry at his teammate there, but I'm sure they'll get over it with a hay and a hoe.
A
hay and a hoe, and then away we go.
Hi ho, here we go for the final, what is maybe the final round. It's 8-5, right?
No, it's not, you didn't switch the sides, dude.
Oh, okay, so it's...
It's 6-7.
Oh god.
You gotta switch the sides, buddy. It's when you switch the sides, because they switch
Germany
teams.
6-7, right?
Fix Ukraine for Germany 7, that's
last,
right.
Fix the P key and then we'll talk about switching sides. P key unlocks the score, FYI.
FYI. Just for your information, P key locks the score in the streamer mod.
That is behind the scenes knowledge. Now you can start your own stream.
You see we've got a lot of internal difficulties in the MBT production right now.
But
a lot
we are back and we love
a lot of tension over the streamer mod and side switching. And there will be some written letters of warning given out after this game.
So the score is 6-7. It's really good right now. This is pretty awesome.
It is. And Ukraine looking really strong as well. I think Germany going to be panicking right now because both teams could win it in normal time. Like, Ukraine could win the next three rounds and just completely take it without even getting to the tiebreak. I think Germany are kind of thinking right now, well, at least we'll probably get at least
Volshin
one round and
in
for a tiebreak.
Position. He is shooting
but
down,
that's not necessarily true.
Targeting the horses. Warring ham.
And the good thing about Volshin is he's a really good shot as well.
Oh, Yona trying to do a duel here, an archer duel. No,
he's trying to whip up there, but it's gonna be like 1-on-2. I think.
A lonely apple hill right now. Pretty full of people though. Thank God there's more than one apple.
It's quite a nice little spot that Yona found there. You can just kind of hide behind that side of the arch there and just reload, pop out and shoot. No one's really taking any damage here though, except for Mendetto.
No, but everyone's looking for that opening. Yona especially.
Yeah. But I was taking a little bit of a hit there. I think that's to his arm, maybe, or something. Well, that's just a spawn on his shield. Oh, yeah, no, he has taken a shot on his arm.
Oh!
Poor guy.
Unfavorable position for Germany. I think Germany's charging really hard now to contest this, so Ukraine don't take it at all. And it seems like that's the case. Nero is just running right up the center.
Yeah, Rich and Flex is getting him again. Rich and Flex raised it about half an inch.
Oh,
down.
They're going to crash!
Got on their horses.
Kappa and Nero are going to crash
coming
the center.
In from two corners here. And Germany didn't split at all. They actually
Germany
split two
didn't
pairs
split. They're
round.
Kind of all grouped up in
they,
that hallway.
They got two players split. The Cav, I think, is going to come from the other side. Mark and Yona. Kills back and forth.
Oh, Ukraine
going very
trying
fast.
To push back.
Very tense here. Ukraine got a... I think they have to do it fast.
Flex
but
coming in
it.
Rather late. Oh, but he comes in right in time. Gets killer.
Brilliant kill from Flex, yeah.
Nice counter
and,
kill by
Ukraine
Mark, but he won't escape.
5-on-3. Sonic
won't
takes down
escape.
Mark here. Just Trari and predictably Yona is one of the last players that's alive here. But I guess that's understandable. It's an archer on situation where the fight went down so fast. And Ukraine, they're loving their cleavers right now. The only issue with Rodox right now is that they just cannot snowball. You cannot snowball as Rodox because their only decent armor is like incredibly expensive.
Tirari's so screwed here. Which will get it first? Oh,
it was a nice movement and he stayed alive quite a while. But great play from Ukraine here, and they're going to be feeling pretty good at 7-7 right now. And Germany they're going to be panicking right now because they've got to win one of the next rounds at least.
Oh my god, it's 7-7. This is very important for these next two rounds. I think Germany kind of threw it away there.
I thought this could be a really good match. I warned you that this could be
exciting. Called it. That's why we're streaming it because it's a good one.
It's a good one.
But yeah, Germany, they knew how to take that area successfully. They flanked it before, and they got a wonderful kill like that. But I think they just rushed it way too hard.
Yeah, I think
you're
right.
They thought Ukraine was out of position, and they thought if they get in there real
well, the issue here is that pretty much because Swarians have weaker infantry, they want to have a slower melee fight than... the faster the fight is, the more important the infantry is. The slower the fight is, the more important the archers are. But right now, I think that Ukraine have the advantage of the strong infantry faction, and the archers that are shooting a little bit better. I mean, other than Yona, who is doing really great, although he still hasn't done that much in this round.
I mean that impressed the Germans. I think.
Yeah, sorry.
Basically, how?
Well, yeah, that wasn't really concise. It got a bit waffly.
No, but the little pearl of wisdom that essentially short skirmishes favor or infantry shine strongest or shine brightest, while long engagements. Archers are the heroes.
Exactly.
And where are the cav? They're just, unsung?
I mean, it's simple mathematics, because the longer the fight goes, the more shots an archer is going to make. In any case.
Horses just...
I think Chirari's been a little bit off his game today. He's normally one of the absolute hero archers of the scene. Very much a Legolas of the scene. But today, not really been up to too much. Has gone
this
to much.
This is very tense. This first kill
it's super tense,
a few things.
And, I think Germany, they're going to be worried now, because going into the set, they're going to be thinking, okay, worst case scenario, it's going to be a tiebreak, and we just have to just sweat it out. But now they're thinking, well, who knows, because, I mean, it's like...
Oh, flag favorably spawns right underneath the foot of Sultanator.
We've seen a very similar-looking round.
Yes, Ukrainians took this improperly last time. What will they do now?
It
seems like... Oh, this is smart. They're trying to fight around the ruins first.
But they do have a different faction this time. That's going to be significant. They're slowing it down. They're not rushing into it. Germany haven't got the flag up too high. Sensible. Sonic UA has actually...
Oh, already causing ruckus up on the
fancy
front.
Helmet there.
German are grouping up together. They're balling. Strength in numbers.
They've managed to clear out the ruins, which is really crucial there. The issue here is going to be Yona and Wayne's positions. Yona's actually getting into the melee fight, which is perhaps a bit of a mistake here. Germany do take the early lead.
That's
a big team kill from Volshin. Takes down Ridge there. Ukraine's starting to choke this.
Ukraine
are going
to have
to pull kills back soon.
Sumrak takes down Killer. That's
a step in direction. But Yona and Nero taking down Sumrak and Bendetto. 7-4 here. Germany looks set to take this round and secure at least the draw here. Flex brings down Zeltonator. It's 3-6 here, though, for Ukraine, and the flag is going up and up and up for Germany. Ipip goes down too, and Flex could save here. I think Flex could be saving his horse.
Oh,
for the last
what a
round.
Nice shot by Triari.
The flag's up. Flex has got to save his horse right now. And it means at least they have the heavy horse there.
Volshin and Flex saving their money, what little money they have left. Now, here it is. Advantage Germany. Ukraine need to win
indeed,
this round, or they are done. They are gone. You will
They've
not
got to
see
win this round
anymore.
To tie break.
And I want to see and Mr. I poop again.
It's been a really, really incredible back and forth mid game, actually.
If you find this match exciting, do what Conti says and spam them kappas.
Spam them kappas.
Spam them kappas for Ukraine. If you want Ukraine to win, spam the kappas.
Dude, that's not what you think of the stream. Obviously, you can tweet me at Captain Lust. Follow, post in chat, do whatever you want to do. Post a comment in the thread as well, that's really helpful, because it stays there, and then I can, not forget about it.
Oh, Ukraine looking around for the enemy, but the enemy awaits them right in the center of the village. Germany, they have some mail armor. Their defenses are a little daunting, but it's not insurmountable. Smart play here, we'll determine what will happen.
No, this is not too snowball-y at all. I think there's a couple of Horburgians and things, but... I mean, there's other things they could have bought, but they just didn't have to sacrifice on. Although they do have some looted cleavers, or at least one, which is always going to be an issue. Because it's weird, the issue is that the cleaver, which is the Rodok's biggest strength, is also their biggest weakness. Like, if your enemy gets a cleaver, it just cuts through, Rodok's dirty little paper armor that just sucks against any sort of big, high-damage cutting weapon like axes and cleavers.
I think that the Ukrainians have a double angle here on the Germans. Oh, the Germans are huddled up tight. They are they're basically holding hands. But, yes, they're also shooting back a little. Seems like Ukrainian have superior archer fire coming at them.
I think Germany's going to sort of huddle up, and wherever the flag goes, it's going to sort of mob towards it, and just try and win the fight like it did before.
That mob...
It was an interesting move from Germany, basically putting their archers into the melee fight there, and I guess it paid off, because they just had a huge mob of players there. It was a really tough team kill from Volshin. He's gonna be really upset about that.
If the flag spawns on Germany's feet, it might as well be a secured victory. But it did not!
No, it's spawned by the execution squad.
It spawned down here!
Well, Germany, but Germany are going to be right there. They're going to be there way before Ukraine are. In fact, it's probably even better for Germany than the other
flag. They're not even going this way. What? They're going a different path. What in the world?
Oh, crazy decisions from
Germany. Oh, Germany with the split decision to chase after Ukraine. What? Will this
And they're
going to
try catching these stragglers, Ben. But no, because Rich and Flex have the back really well covered.
Oh, my God. They're running so fast, but I don't know.
It's great discipline from Ukraine, who are completely covered
in
the area.
Germany does not do their best when they get there late. And they are late as heck.
And the issue is that Ukraine are raising a flag.
Set up.
Oh, brilliant shot from Bolshin. Gets that kill as Germany entering the area. Rekovi goes up to try and, sort of put him out of business.
Bentopa getting shot up a little.
Triari
is in a great position as well, though. Bolshin is now
being chased away. Takes a big hit from Rich. The issue is that I think Ukraine needs some help on
the
flag.
The issue is the big fight in the center.
They need some cap support to Ukraine, and Flex comes in now to give it. But it's a bit late as Warring and Mori takes down Qantas. 7-on-7 right now.
Oh, Ukraine Sonic and Nero fighting it out.
On a team go from Rich, I think Ukraine really choked this in a really important moment. 6-on-6.
Unfortunate one. No!
Takes down Rich too.
Another Rich
finally
death.
Bring out the kills.
Bullshit's still shooting.
But Flex is still up. It's 4-on-6 here. But Triari is unchallenged over by that Ruin and is just sniping out the Ukrainian players right now. Oh, just...
Oh,
I think the Ukrainian
no,
captain is a bit too disappointed
in
Germany.
Ukrainians!
Are looking to put the Ukrainians out of this.
I poop craps
Sumac
himself,
has
he's
left.
Gone!
Rich has left.
Flex doesn't even
red.
Know
and
who
the Ukrainians
to shoot anymore!
Are giving up on this map. They're giving up on this game.
Oh no!
Germany are saying GG. Triari is just picking them off one by one
People
here.
People leaving the game!
Fantastic play by Germany.
Volshin
requesting
a duel!
In the very last round.
Volshin requests a duel
Volshin
out of
wants
honor.
A duel.
I don't think they're gonna
Germany
give it to him.
Have no idea what
they're
to do.
They're gonna
with
give
it.
Him something else, that's for sure.
I think that would have been a
duel. Bolshin angry! Bolshin
wins
so
the duel!
Mad.
And Triari slaps him out. And fantastic play by Germany there to see it off in the very end of that. That's going to put it at a 9-7 win for Germany. That's going to see the game out for us. That's going to put Germany through to. Going to put Germany through to the quarterfinals. And going to see Ukraine out of the tournament, which is crazy, really. I mean, it would have been, I suppose, would it have been even crazy to see Germany out because Germany won the whole thing last year. But for Ukraine to go out, it's odd because Ukraine is seen as one of the great warbanding nations.
One of
they
the
just work it out.
Warbanding nations.
Like, what, is Shawnee Voron Russian then or something? Because Shawnee Voron.
That's an auspicious title.
Well, the thing is, typically Shawnee Voron and Rich work together as a cab pair, in their team. Karakteniki.
That was such a close match, and it seemed like all the blocks were in place for Ukraine to push it into overtime. But they flubbed it up.
They
really
did. They choked
it.
They took some really rough team kills, and it was that was a real shame. Like
you can't stop the
Ukraine
German advance, man.
But yeah, but a shame that Ukraine couldn't do it because I mean they were just sort of they were kind of behind throughout the whole game, just sort of just behind. They pulled it back to 7-7, but Germany just held their nerve and saw it through. So I'm impressed with Germany. I certainly don't want to take anything away from that win.
Ukraine on their heels the whole match. Unfortunately,
I think they're gonna have a tough time in the quarterfinals though. They're gonna be working hard, and this will give them a second chance to improve on their performance because they took a really tough loss against Scandinavia. But if they can do it, then who knows not until the finals, I think, I assume.
If they both get there.
I don't know who they're fighting. I don't know if the bracket's set yet. I don't think it is. But let's see if we can get an interview with a German player. I don't know.
With a German?
The German player, yeah.
Well, still, nonetheless, that was a very exciting match of Nations Cup.
There's an interesting missing player as well there from the German team who was... Furunian. He normally plays a cav player, but I'm not sure exactly where he was. Well, I wonder, but he's quite important. I think we have a double interview here. I think RenKB is going to come in with Yona. So that'd be nice.
But who else is arriving?
Yona. The player that was always there until the last.
Yeah,
the
but Yona
was always like,
who else?
RenKB is the captain.
Yeah, Ukraine out.
Ukraine out, yeah.
Bags right now.
And no interview for them.
The losers get no spotlight, but they get our respect for wonderful entertainment in a fight.
Oh, of course, yeah.
Fight.
But, and they did play well. They showed some real spirit, and especially Volshin and Benedetto, Richmond Flex sort of were really great throughout the game. I've listed two. I've complimented two new players.
Is this the end of I Poop?
It is, unfortunately.